Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel charts, chapter 6, mixing chart types. All right, so, you know, some people kind of complained after Excel 2003 because the mixed chart types disappeared from the wizard. You no longer have the column line charts. Well, you can still create them. They're just harder to do. But actually, when you get right down to it, you need to be able to do it this way anyway because you want to have some control. So here I have monthly sales going across. I also have two other lines that are yearly numbers. So the year-to-date sales and our goal for the whole year. I want to create a nice chart showing how our sales progressed towards the goal. So I'm going to insert. I'm just going to create everything as a column chart, a 2D column. Let's make this a little bit smaller. Okay, so a couple things. We really lose the detail of the smaller items. So I want to take those smaller chart items and move them to a secondary axis. Actually, I want to leave the small items there and take the other two items and move those to a secondary axis. So I'm going to choose the year-to-date number. I'm going to do Control 1 to get to Format, or on the Layout tab, click Format Selection, or in Excel 2010, double-click. Any of those will work. And I'm going to move that to the secondary axis. All right, and then I'm also going to choose the third item, the goal, and move that to a secondary axis. So right there, be able to choose that, put that on the secondary axis. And let's see how this looks so far. All right, so now we have our monthly sales numbers tied to the left axis and our year-to-date numbers tied to the right axis. I want to put a lot of focus on those month numbers and make the other items just be simple lines. So we have the goal chosen. I'm going to go back to the design tab and say change chart type, and I'm going to change that to a line with dots. Now the cool thing is once you change that to a line and change this one to a line, so again, change chart type, choose a line. Now you can really kind of see through and you can actually see the various monthly sales. All right, want to make those monthly sales a bit more prominent. Choose that item. We'll do format cells again, Control 1. And I'm going to make the columns wider by making the gap narrower. Click close. Want to add some indication that the numbers along the left are tied to those blue columns. So we'll choose those numbers. Then on the Home tab, change the font color to match the color of the bars. All right, so now we have a nice chart showing our sales month by month by month. We know what our total goal was here. It was constant throughout the year and how we progressed towards that goal over the course of the year. So now here's a chart where we combine one series as columns, two other series as lines. You know, although we weren't able to just choose that from the first step of the wizard, in fact, the first step of the wizard, it would have been very unlikely that it ever would have had a chart where the first series was columns, second and third series were lines. So just being able to go through and control that bit by bit by bit really gives you a lot more chance to come up with a chart that's going to match exactly what you're looking for. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.